Welcome to the Ignorance of Strength podcast. I'm your host, Fabian motherfucking Ojeda, and I don't know shit, but that's okay.
All right, let's get this shit started. Thank you, everybody, for listening to the Ignorance of Strength podcast. Hope you all enjoyed all of the other fucking episodes up to this point. We're at episode number 100. Right, episode number 100, and we're gonna celebrate with a little bit of Earth, Wind, and Fire here. Potter's doing the white boy Oprah bite dance. You can't see it, right? You can feel it. Potter, give me some more of that white boy Oprah bite. Make noises. Woo! Grunt. There you go.
Grunt.
But how do you guys? We're back with the regular shit show crew here. So we got Whitey.
Hey.
We're not gonna add the booze this time because it's all about celebrating. We got Sosa and we got Potter. Apparently, unfortunately, we don't have the wet ass P word, but maybe that's a little bit played out by now. How do you guys feel about hitting that milestone 100?
It's crazy to think it's been 100.
Yeah, can't imagine that it's 100 now.
That's pretty fucking cool. I didn't think it was.
We're at the 10th shit show, technically.
Mm-hmm.
That means you've sat down 100 times and talked with different people.
Yeah, or the same people. I mean, that means that there's like fucking 100 hours roughly.
We've had to have new conversations each time. It's kind of crazy.
Fuck, man. It feels almost like yesterday when we did the first shit show. At least to me.
I thought so too. I mean, at some point, which is another one after another one after another one. And it's like we go, I think, like 2 months in between almost, right? Two and a half months in between.
A solid 2 months. Maybe sometimes we record a bit earlier, but yeah.
Never feels like that long, though.
No, we always instinctively go back to talking shit to one another as soon as the camera's on.
Uh-huh. And with that said, what's some new shit we got to talk over here?
Throw it to Whitey first. What do you got, Whitey?
I think the biggest thing right now is that Ukraine shit going on right now with Russia. That's the biggest thing for me last couple of days.
For reference, everybody, Whitey had his Russian flag on in the Zoom background. Right? I don't know what he was doing, but that's what we saw. Are you going to argue that one, Whitey?
No, that never happened.
I could have sworn he was playing their national anthem, too, just a minute ago.
You know, Whitey's the only guy that I know that was actually rooting for the Russian guy in Rocky IV. I mean, I don't know
it was Dolph Lundgren. I mean, how are you not going to root for him? Sylvester Stallone obviously had a lot of brain damage at that point.
If you look at his speech,
You can basically track the brain damage from Rocky 1 to Rocky 4.
Yeah, well, you know, that strength that comes with those blows, you can see him in a six-pack that he got.
Have you guys ever seen footage of Stallone directing the Rocky movies?
No.
He's like in there with Carl Weathers. That guy's pretty friggin' amazing when it comes to directing that shit, really. I'd check it out if I were you. Yeah, he's really like throwing these punches, like it looked like he could have hurt his neck or something during some of the shit.
I agree with that because it's like a movie, right? And you're supposed to be a little bit ridiculous. But if he was choreographing an actual boxing fight, like that looked nothing like a real boxing fight.
What are you talking about? That was the most realistic shit I've ever seen.
Yeah. Oh yeah. All the power punches and
all the haymakers.
Yeah. straight to the canvas, right? it's like every heavyweight fight I've ever seen. That's how
I can't stand watching regular boxing. It's too fucking boring, dude.
I don't know.
No? You like Mayweather fights?
Yeah, actually.
Are you fucking dips and dodges for all but the last 10 seconds of each round?
That shit's an art, man.
I mean, I heard them. I think it was a Joe Rogan talking about how smart he is about not trying to catch brain damage, but man, it's a fucking boring ass match.
He does what he's supposed to do though. Like, I used to hate him for years because of what Potter's saying, and because I felt like he ruined the sport for me. But really, he just played the sport to his advantage. I mean, really, like, he cherry picked all his opponents. Like, he did all those things. At the end of the day, it's hit and don't get hit, and that's what he does. So who's to get mad at that guy for playing by the rules that they let him play by? I think you have to look at the boxing commissions who create these unfair systems for everybody, because they let things get way out of control.
Damn. Way to go in depth there, Whitey. No, that's really nice. Good argument. Your rebuttal, Mr. Potter.
I'm going to pile on Potter here.
Go on.
I'm pile on Potter because you say you don't like watching regular boxing, which infers to me that, implies to me that you were talking about liking MMA a little better. Is that what you're getting at right there?
I hardly watch MMA to begin with, just because it's on pay-per-views. But if I do get a chance to watch it, I'll watch it. And I think in the MMA matches, they encourage more of like some sort of contact to happen. You're like, come on, move, like attack your opponent.
And see, I disagree with that though, because I watch a little bit of everything, right? A little bit of boxing, a little bit of MMA. And sometimes there's MMA fights are just as boring or more. And I hate to say it because I'm a wrestler, but because some of the wrestlers don't do anything for the whole, 5 minutes, right? And instead of watching, like a boring boxing fight, it's three minute rounds, right? So maybe they'll get in there and run around and maybe a hug at different times and shit, right? But a fucking 5 minute MMA round where the guy's just, holding the same position in guard or half guard or whatever, that's more boring than a boxing fight where they're actually moving around at least, that's the way I look at it. Or a jiu-jitsu guy constantly butt scooting.
I fucking hate that. I hate the butt scooting.
Butt scooting is the worst. I hate it when people try to pull guard.
It's the dumbest
fucking thing. It should not be allowed. It's doing that tells me that you don't want to like engage with in the match properly.
Mm-hmm.
That's how I feel about it. You're just completely opting out of a lot of practicality. Yeah. And it at least like in an MMA match, if the guys are clinching up against the cage or hitting, they're just waiting for that one little mistake. And I know that that's what they're waiting for that guy to make that one little mistake. And then he's going to throw the guy to the ground and then go for a mount or a submission. And yeah, like jiu-jitsu, man, it's fucking chess, not checkers. And sometimes you gotta wait and bide your time and do something else to make an opening happen. But fucking boxing's just don't get hit, but hit him.
I don't know. But like, okay, so you don't like Mayweather because he didn't get hit, right? He wouldn't engage the way you want him to engage. However, I would argue that Canelo has like developed that same style where you can't hit that motherfucker. I mean, he's like goddamn Neo from the Matrix in there. You throw everything you got at him, he slips, he dips, he dodges everything. And I think his fights are super exciting.
Yeah, because he ends it when he wants to.
Yeah, yeah, he really does. He picks apart his opponent and he's like, when he's done, he's done. But like when you hear his interviews afterwards, it's like, what does he say? Oh, quería una pelea muy bonita. Like he wanted to have a good match. He's like, I want to put on a show.
I don't know. But you know what? We're talking about combat sports here. At the time of recording right now, today's state finals.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So I know this is like the second or third year that we don't go. But I just remember just going to watch the fucking state finals every year. I think they moved it now. I don't think it's in Bakersfield anymore. I think it's in might be a little bit further up north in Fresno, I think.
But, hey, so how close did you get to making state finals this year?
I wouldn't make weight if I tried, man. I wouldn't make. None of us would. Well, you guys, might make heavyweight.
What's He's the heavyweight over there in high school again?
Heavyweight ends like at 240, doesn't it?
No, it ends at 285.
What's it begin at?
215.
Now I think they have like a 220 division, so I think it's like at 221 now. I don't know. It's all the weights are all different. I have no idea. There's a new coach at Mountain View too. Apparently, who used to wrestle at South Del Monte when we were at Mountain View. So he graduated in 04. And they're building like a Hall of Fame wall or something in the wrestling room. I'm thinking like it's gonna have like one name.
Yeah, who?
Well, there was a guy I think that was a state champ, a Chris Abrego. He's big in like TV as well. I think he had stuff like on HBO and whatnot. He came one time to teach us like a little clinic on something. I forget what it was, like something about your stance and something simple.
I vaguely remember that.
Remember he was talking about you have to have your pistols downward?
Yeah,
I remember that.
That's
guy.
What it was. Yeah.
So I think he's the only one that really made it far, unless you like dig deeper in the past, but I have no idea. I don't know what happened after us, but I don't think anybody was really noteworthy other. I think was one of Yoshi's brothers or nephews or whatever pretty successful as well.
I think maybe CIF,
maybe Masters.
I don't know.
I think the year or two after we graduated.
Hey, but
the team got to CIF.
Like yeah, team, but that like was team, on a technicality yeah. because Rosemary got disqualified.
Oh shit!
Hey man, I'll take that.
Didn't hear that.
Yeah, I mean, they did well because he did. I think I don't know if it was a third place or second place finish after Rosemary got disqualified, but I mean it was on technicality. Now
hey, what's up with that?
If they want to put most pins in one season. You know, I still kept my own records. Granted, there's no way to verify this now, probably about almost 20 years later. But I'm just saying, if they want to throw a wall of fame up there, you got to have most pins in a season. That would be me, 35 pins in one season, senior year, guaranteed it. I can tell you exactly where those pins happened. So, new coach, if you want to put me on that wall of fame, I deserve a spot. There's not going to be that many people on there. Come talk to me. You know, we'll make it happen. I'll put on a new singlet too if you want. You know, I don't mind.
You know, if we're talking about you know the wall and recognition, if you want to put in a section of who took a shit at every school they went to wrestle at, that's this guy right here.
Dude, you went and took your own toilet paper every time.
I fucking destroyed those toilets, and I did bring my own toilet paper before it was cool.
What are you two getting on the wall of fame for? Nothing.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, man,
fucking chumps.
The only guy that pinned a Rosemead.
Put your fucking fingers down, Potter.
That's not true. I pinned Nick a couple times.
True. Yeah, I've also pinned them as well before, multiple times.
But in a senior year league match.
Hmm?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. No.
Big finals.
Yeah.
Yeah. That'll put you down a peg, Potter.
Yeah.
You want to live off of that accomplishment 20 years later?
Those is four touchdowns in one game.
Oh.
Listen.
Who am I?
Yeah, listen. I was like, listen, I gave you the assist there, Potter. Had I not motivated you, you still would. I don't think he would have finished the season. I think he would have dropped out from depression at that point because nobody was rooting for you. But when you saw that a teammate, your captain, your humble captain, right, was rooting humble for you and you know, put you on the right path and everything, you know, you had something to win for.
If you say so, Fabian, if you say so.
It's like that wet ass P word. I wish I had the song to queue up and they didn't take it out from YouTube.
Yeah,
that's the benefit. Maybe we need to make this show, video friendly, because that's the benefit. That's the benefit of having Zoom for us. We can see the backgrounds here. Nobody else can see it. So they're just thinking we have dead silence. If we don't, you think that you can kiss my ass. Anyway, we might have failed to mention this at the top of the show, but we might have some guests log in at some point. At any point, why are you over there making Ben Shapiro smoke the doobie? I like it. But if they chime in, we'll go ahead and we'll drop what we're doing and just kind of welcome them and see what they want to say, and then we'll go from there. I don't think they're going to stay the whole shit show, but just to give you guys some know-how and protocol about what we do in case that happens.
And if that doesn't happen, we're just going to delete this whole section and pretend it never happened.
Yeah. Pretty much.
Oh God. Can we delete Isaac's part where he took credit for that pin? I mean, if we're taking votes, I'm voting for that.
God damn it, Potter.
I notion to delete, strike that from the record.
I don't care.
Denied.
Guys, he still believes it.
You know, I wonder if they go in that wrestling room and they do practice the Potter. They're like, this is what you do when you have an opponent who's more highly skilled than you are.
Dude, don't be a Potter, bro.
And rides the shit out of that leg, right? Right? You simply reach back and you pull a Potter.
Do you think they have a clinic for adjusting your singlet while they're giving that leg ride?
Oh, that guy was a dick, man.
Oh.
Let me adjust my singlet. Let me adjust my headgear.
Right, you need to snap the singlet straps like suspenders.
That's pretty gangster.
Did you feel violated at that point, Butter, or just kind of you had to laugh with it?
Motherfucker, when it was happening, I had no idea what was going on.
You should have farted on him, dude.
Fucking when, dude? It was like a 30-second match.
Should have sharded right there. Like, that's how you get revenge, you know?
Exactly. You had 30 seconds, man. You blew it.
Totally blew it.
Yeah, you know, like, let me ask you guys. This is a dirty fucking tactic in wrestling that I am embarrassed to admit is a thing, but everybody knows it, even non-wrestlers. But the dreaded oil check, you know what I'm talking about. I'm not fucking making those faces. Right?
Did
any of you poor souls ever get oil checked during a match?
No, thank goodness.
No.
I would say it's like the Great White Buffalo. Everybody hears about it, but I've never seen it.
Fucking, I heard about it. That
can you stop smiling while you say that, please?
What was this? Like, some dumb fuck that wrestled at Rosemead, and like he went to go coach like a season at Mountain View.
Oh, okay.
He's like, yeah, man, just like going through the match, and then you just fucking oil check the guy and like throws him off, and then like then you throw the half. I'm like,
yeah, no.
What the fuck?
And then later on afterwards, you take him out to dinner.
Did that guy just admit to diddling kids? Is that what I just heard?
Yeah.
I mean, he was.
Sure sounds like it.
I mean, it kind of sounds like he was diddling kids.
Yeah, because you have to demonstrate it, right?
I need a demonstrator.
And he's going to be, you know, he's going to be like fucking penetrating right there.
That's with the amount of diddlers that did come back and coach wrestling, that's
good enough to beat Mountain View, though. And he's like, the fuck, how is that something to be proud about, to be like fucking oil checking guys during a match?
I don't know. I'm done with this conversation here. I brought it up, Potter, but you just made it like disgusting. I was just gonna say something juvenile, you know, but somebody take over real quick. I gotta walk away from this real quick.
Oh my God.
I want to hear about your dead dogs in your shop. Why do you question the turkeys?
Oh my god.
What the fuck?
Oh my god.
There are no dead dogs in my shop, sir. How dare you?
Currently no dead dogs.
Currently. We did the dead dog check before we turned on the camera.
Why do you do your duty as a co-host and interrogate this son of a bitch?
So what's up with these dogs, man? Like as a groomer, I'm sure you've had your share of close calls or maybe, you know, curtain calls. any mishaps happen while you're that you have to explain to people what happened to their animal at your pet store, Potter? I guess is the best question here.
Give you a very disgusting story if you'd like.
Well, you already have, so let's hear it.
All right, so somebody brought in like this this small terrier of like 20, 25 pounds, give or take, and the dog was matted. And so when the dog is really mad, we do a shave down, okay? Just go shortest blade possible to cut off all the hair. So Macy's in the back and she's shaving the dog, and she's getting towards like the dog's like lower back, still on the spine. And all of a sudden, there's just like this giant circle of flesh that is being eaten alive by maggots.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
So what'd you do?
We immediately stopped and fucking called the owner and told him, hey, your dog has a giant open wound on its back and there's fucking maggots in it. But we probably didn't say fucking maggots in it, but we just said it has maggots in it. And he's like, what? And like he came back and he saw, he's like, oh my god. And then you took the dog to the vet, because that is not some shit you can just blame on us for no reason.
Yeah.
He's been a loyal customer ever since. He keeps coming back.
How are the maggots now?
Gone. Dead.
Did he name him?
I would like to take a quick pause. We have a guest coming in. It looks like we have Astro Monica. I don't know if y'all have listened to her episode.
Oh, yeah.
Absolutely.
But we do have Astro Monica coming in to say hello or congratulations, but to give us some kudos here. And we're going to continue playing our celebration song here. I don't know if you can hear us.
We could hear her.
Damn it. How long do I have to play Earth, Wind, and Fire? They're going to take this down off of YouTube because of the copyright claims. Taking it down now. Can't celebrate that much. All right, let's see if she's there. We have somebody here. There we go.
It's me.
So for hello. For the 100th time, we have Astro Monica back, and she's all the way from Texas today, right?
Yes, I'm in Houston, Texas today.
Nice. So you dropped in to be part of the 100 episode celebration?
Yeah, I kind of had to because you kind of obligated me. No, I'm just kidding.
I was like, you don't jump
you
in.
Better get on that fucking video call. I beg you, you better. I'm just kidding with you, Vivian.
I was going to say, you better get on there, otherwise you never talk about your fucking rocks again.
It's so funny because my boyfriend's talking about his Moldavite, and he's like, yeah, we're too lost in our rocks right now, so let's just leave it at that point.
And you know, it doesn't have to be anything today to have you on to anything extensive. You know, I just invited anybody who's been on before to just kind of, you know, drop by. You know, talk a little bit about, you know, in retrospect, you know, what they enjoyed about the podcast. And then we'll hopefully have, you know, everybody on again at some point. So you've got the floor.
Me? Okay. I guess it was a very whole different opportunity for me and also for you, I'm assuming. And I really enjoyed, like, the different talks that you had, different people you had on your show, because it wasn't just like once or and it's like the very unknown people, let's just put it that way. And we just got super popular at different countries. That's what I love the most. I made like 14K in India, and I didn't know I was that famous in India.
Actually, yeah, the downloads were, I think, were like 22,000.
See, I'm the one bringing you the money, Vivian. So I have to be on the show all the time.
Well, I wish.
Hold the fuck on. There's money?
There's no money.
Hang on. There's money?
Yeah, we spent most of our shows insulting India. I think that's the problem. That's why you have no money.
Well, we did have listeners in the Ukraine up until this week.
And then, boom.
We actually did, though. We had Ukraine listeners.
That's cool.
And then it dropped off this week.
I think Ukraine has bigger issues right now. To be fair, that flag is the Chinese communist flag. Is it not?
Not the sickle one. Isn't the Chinese one with the stars and one large star and the smaller ones?
I brought you out of hiding, Isaac. I knew you.
Right, we just finally spotted the commie.
There it is.
Yeah. Why do you know so much about communist flags, Potter?
I know where not to go.
That's a good response. I'll give you that one.
He's been learning Russian.
But I'll get back to our guest real quick, Astro Monica. Have you listened to any of the shit shows with any of these guys?
I probably have. I just don't remember. I listen to a lot of podcasts sometimes, and I get lost in a podcast world.
Did any of you all listen to Astro Monica's episodes?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and the one with Roy too. She was on with Roy.
Oh, with Roy.
Yes.
Yeah. I told Roy about this. I was hoping he would jump on.
Oh, yeah.
I haven't really spoken to Roy at all. I've been deactivated on Facebook for a while, so haven't been on Facebook lately. But I found out he actually deleted me off his friend list, now that I remember.
Uh-oh. So what?
He deleted me off his friend list.
Well, what'd you do?
He got upset because I got a boyfriend.
Dun, dun, dun.
Oh, we're going to ask Roy about that.
It was so funny because I was going to my friend. I'm like, what happened to Roy? Because I was going to ask him if we were ever going to do that podcast, like, I guess, number three with him. And I was scrolling, and I realized, I'm like, oh, shit, he's actually not even on my friend. So when I went back to my messages, because I think I had, several messages from him, back in April. And I guess he probably thought I just didn't want to talk to him anymore. So when I clicked on it, I was like, oh, shit, I had, about 6 messages, I think. Ooh. Or something like that. I'm not even sure.
In all fairness.
I don't really read messages at all. I just kind of, let them linger there. It's just,
It almost sounds like you left him lingering there.
No, but I was never really giving him any hope. God, I don't want to talk about this because it sounds terrible. But
poor Roy.
We are getting the other side of perspective of the friend zone right now. Please continue, Monica. How did you put somebody in the friend zone?
This is interesting. Yes,
I am not very active on Facebook. Mm-hmm. I do mm-hmm. Facebook continue. Because I have. There was some issues going on, and I decided to leave Facebook. And I was MIA on Instagram too. I don't know if you realize that, Vivian. I was kind of gone for a while.
Okay. Yeah.
Right. Yeah. I was trying to get my shit together. That's all. Okay. But now with Roy.
Now, in Roy's defense, at the end of that episode that y'all did together, he did in a very longing way, just be like, hey, just say hi every now and then. It doesn't have to be all the time. Just mm-hmm. every now and then. And you agreed. Mm-hmm. And you agreed.
I would say that's putting his hopes up.
And I did. But then, I don't know what happened. I really was just, he's just a little weirdo, I guess.
At some point, the highs stopped coming.
Mm-hmm. No. They withered away.
It's very often. I think the last time, because I don't really use Facebook because it's all my family that I and I really don't like talking to them, so I kind of just lingered away from Facebook. And I just recently activated because I had a family member that was doing a funeral, so that's the only reason why I activated to see my messages. But other than that, I was okay. you know. But yeah, that's a story about about Roy. He just deleted me off his friend list, so I was like, okay, I wasn't offended at all. It's fine.
I don't think I've ever defriended anyone. Have you guys ever defriended anyone on online? Like, I mean, I don't think I ever have. I've been defriended.
No, because I'm never on social media, so those people just kind of stay there. I don't accept new friends either, which I think offends some people, but it's because I'm never on. So, like, I'll get on probably like once a year or something like that, kind of like to get something, but or to look at like a picture or something. But other than that, I'm not really on like Facebook or anything.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that. Potter, you're kind of on there, but you don't really stay active, right? You just like a bunch of shit.
Yeah, exactly.
Share a bunch of shit. And Sosie is no longer on. God damn. Done. Am I the biggest social media fucking, you know, person here? That's not my thing.
Well, apparently it is. Look at that.
Fuck, you plan to go back on Sosa or just nah, you're done?
Not really. I'm done.
Well, goddamn, there goes that. Now I'm gonna have to learn how to tweet and shit.
Gonna have to send you
guys have my number, you know,
text message. Man, you know how much fucking harder that takes. I've been sending Fabian all this stuff. I'm like, Sosa will be back one day and he'll see this fucking shit. Maybe he'll laugh a bit. He's never coming back now.
Mm-hmm.
Now who's he gonna send? Now it just goes straight to me, right? All the actually none of it has been political. I think Potter, you've tempered your, you know, your style a little bit to realize that if it's funny or if it includes wrestling, I'll watch it. So I give you kudos for that. But we do have that thread that says Whitey not here.
Now Sosa not here either.
God damn it.
I'll just start sending it to you directly and Fabian into the group chat. But whatever.
But anyway, Astro Monica, you're free to stay with us online, or you can just say your bit and let the podcast world know you've been grateful for being on the last 10 times and give us kudos.
I give you kudos, Vivian. Sorry, I'm trying to gather my thoughts because I got to pack for tomorrow because I'm leaving tomorrow morning back to LA. So I'm surprised you even asked me to hop on. I was like, I haven't heard from you lately. So I was like, oh, Vivian probably just doesn't want to talk about Astro anymore because I had some really good conversations. And like, I wanted to tell you what's going to happen in the next 2 years, but I was like, we'll get to that eventually someday.
In about 2 years?
So we it's so funny because we actually return. We the United States enter their Pluto return, which is like it means that the planet Pluto rotates 247 years in order for it to go around the whole solar system thing. And I guess now we enter, so that's why it's starting the World War III. Like people say, and it's gonna last for like 2 years, but other than that, I mean, we should be fine. So it's no biggie.
World War III is no biggie.
I was gonna say, did you just dismiss the importance of World War III?
I mean, there's so many things going on right now. It's just so chaotic, and it's just too much. I just will just say that, you know, gas is gonna go up. We might lose electricity. Our GPS might be off because they're gonna try to probably like hack into like all that stuff, and there's a lot of conspiracies going on. So
Fabian, you need to cue up their national anthem music anytime Whitey fucking changes his background.
What's that?
You need to cue up Russia's, the USSR's national anthem. Every time Whitey fucking changes it.
I'll just do Zangief's song from Street Fighter, because I'm not looking up Soviet anything. I don't want to be canceled here. Definitely, thank you, Astro Monica, for being on it. Yeah, maybe we'll hear about that at some point. But go ahead and pack. Do your thing, and I appreciate you being part of the first 100 episodes here. for sure.
Thank you. So, no, thank you, Fabian. Really appreciate it. I know probably the last podcast was kind of like, people were like, fuck this bitch, because she's talking about homelessness. So
I thought that one was good. It was different.
You know, I never heard any feedback from you, so that's why I was like, okay, Fabian, thanks for making
me feel what I do my job. You just mentioned you were off of social media for like a decade or whatever, so.
Hit me up on my business page. I was still on my business page doing things on there. Not my personal page, just my business page.
Just giving you business about the business.
Yes, yes. I was being a businesswoman, okay?
All right, but yeah, I appreciate it. Hopefully we get some more visitors in right now. I'll definitely, you know, check in and we can have another episode about the dismissing World War III and the solar system fucking us and whatnot.
Episode 200, the war is over.
All right, Vivian, thanks. Right. I'll see you later though.
It was nice to see you.
Bye, guys. Have a good one.
Bye.
Bye. Take it easy.
The solar system, guys.
Yeah, the solar system.
Sosa almost outed his disdain right now by accidentally chatting everyone except directly messaging me. But I'll just leave it at that.
I play the fifth, man.
It was great.
Well, you know what? At least we don't have to cut out that part that we said we might have to cut out if there were nobody dropped in. We had a drop in. That's something.
You know, the benefit of having the shit show is that even if it's like complete shit, and, a complete
which mess, let's be honest, it mostly is.
That's the whole point, right?
The shit show is just shooting the shit.
Yeah, yeah, but also, you know, if it turns out to be a shit show, it is what it is.
Yeah. Yeah, I always took it as you spend every episode talking about a certain topic. This is the episode for no topics, like not anything in particular.
Yeah, no, I mean that's also true, you know, because you're right. The first episodes were all about something specific, right? And then, you know, we when we did the shit show, it was about anything and everything.
Yeah.
Right.
Yes, sir.
Which is good, but Potter, did you finish that dead dog story or maggot dog story?
Yeah, the maggot dog story's gone.
Now, did you have another that you can tell that's safe, where it won't get you into any trouble, or that doesn't have any pending litigation?
Let's see what I got here.
So hey, I'm still missing that barbecue, by the way.
What barbecue?
Fabian.
Oh.
What's that?
I said I'm still missing that barbecue, by the way.
I know, man. I haven't made it like to sell or anything. I got lazy about it.
How's that? How's the freaking smoker you got? The one that's all digital and shit. You digging that?
Yeah, it's still out there, fucking cranking it up every now and then. But you know, meat's expensive as fuck right now, man.
Hell yeah,
that shit's only gonna go up, if anything.
Yeah, so I haven't used it as much as I would like to, but, you know, I never turned down an opportunity for that.
I don't understand why that would go up anyway. Like, what happened? All the cows died off or something like that?
Oh,
people are gouging, dude.
The people voted and they passed a law that farmers have to be more humane towards the cattle.
I guess we're all going to be eating fucking Impossible Burgers and shit soon.
So you need to have less animals in a pen, or you need to, and if you want to have the same amount of animals, they would have had to expand their property,
so
have larger pens. And since they can't do that, thus they must raise their prices for meat.
So instead of chickens, maybe you should be thinking about raising cows, Potter. Or maybe a delicious lamb here or there. Would it kill you? Huh?
You know, then you mentioned
the wife's trying to get me to get goats. And I'm like, no.
Dude, get a lamb, dude. Goats are no fucking fun. They're a big hassle. Lambs, you don't gotta worry about jumping over your fucking whatever. Well, actually you do, huh?
I love goat beauty. What are you talking about, man?
When you count sheep, don't they jump over like a fence or something like that? Like,
No, but they'll jump off. They'll jump on top of anything, and just like chill out there, and like climb up stuff.
Now, why do you briefly mention their, you know, fucking impossible meats or whatever? Like, that shit's even more expensive than real meat.
Is it really? I've never had it.
Mm-hmm.
Have you tried it?
I think I had one, like a fast food burger by accident.
Yeah.
Like that was like Impossible or whatever the other company is, Beyond.
And I don't know. And Verdict.
I could tell the difference. Like it tastes more like, you know, like bread almost.
They even got like Impossible Chicken at like Panda Express. Mm-hmm. Like you can get orange chicken that's not, well, you can't even call it chicken. You can get orange chicken like substance.
I mean,
I don't understand why if they're decided not to eat meat, they want something to look and taste just like meat for some dumb reason.
I don't get that.
Fucking, you don't eat meat. Fine. Don't eat meat. Just eat your veggies. Stop trying to impose a fucking fake ass wannabe meat substitute.
You know,
as my food.
Pass it off as like, okay, it's more healthy. Is it though? Because it's got all kinds of preservatives and shit.
I looked it up one time, man. There's a shit ton of sodium in them.
So it's not more healthy. They try to pass it off as like, oh, well, you'll save money because you won't be buying as much meat. Really? Because all the Impossible patties are way more than like a regular burger patty, you know. My brother's wife, she was like vegetarian or whatever. And when we would buy, you know, Beyond Meats or Impossible anything, it would be way more expensive than, you know, regular hot dogs or regular burgers. So it's not saving you money. It's not more healthy. You know, I don't understand what benefit a meat eater would gain from switching over to something like that.
Yeah.
And it doesn't taste any better.
If I'm not going to have meat, I'll just have salad.
But I guess, yeah. I mean,
if those are my options, fucking salad or the Impossible meat, just give me the fucking salad and I'll be
fine. I'll have chicken salad or tuna salad. I'm good.
Why is he going to throw like some bacon bits in there? Croutons and stuff.
Only if those pigs were spaced out far enough when they were being fucking raised for our consumption. And they read bedtime stories every night or whatever.
You know why this started? Because all you people started going to Chipotle. I called it right from the beginning, right? You replace that C with an S, and that's exactly what I think about Chipotle, right? Where people were like, oh, but they treat their chickens so well, you know? And it's responsibly raised and blah, blah, blah. It's like, I don't give a damn if you put that chicken in a fucking spa. You know, when it's all cooked and fried and shit, like nobody cares at the end of the day. I don't think you can tell a difference, right?
I think food at Chipotle is terrible, man. Like, but I think that because we live in Southern California and we get all the good stuff over here, you know.
I don't think they should call it a Mexican grill. There's nothing Mexican grill about it.
Agreed.
The delivery system, burritos and. Maybe the quesadillas, but
yeah. I mean, that's, you know, I hate to admit it, but the burrito is an American thing, you know. it's not a Mexican creation. Sosa right here. Like, as far as you know, why you brought up the whole, you know, we're gonna have to resort to eating fucking Beyond Meat or fucking. The imitation meats, right? What's your take on those? You a fan of those at all?
Uh-uh.
Have you had it before?
No.
That's simple enough, right? Simple enough.
No.
What I'm saying is it all started with the Chipotle people, right? And their love for chickens that are raised on a spa. They treat their chickens so well, you know?
Yeah, but like treating, you know, poultry or whatever humanely It's different than having Beyond Meat. I mean, that's not even, like, it didn't even come from a fucking animal. That's weird.
I think I'm going to jump the gun here and try to correlate the two. The whole, I treat my chickens well, led to, like Potter said, you got this, now you have to buy more space for your farm, right? And you have to, and we're not going to buy meat from you unless you treat your chickens well, or you treat your cows well, right? And so now meat costs too much, right? And now, now because meat costs too much, let's try to eat more fucking vacation shit, right? I know that's a big jump from one to the other, but that's the way I'm going to look at it.
You're here.
I will be.
Just give me my fucking meat. I don't want that goddamn.
Where does it all end, though? Now the chickens need a college education.
Yeah, you need to send your chickens to college before you can fucking cook them up anymore.
These chickens graduated from Chicken U.
I'm glad pigs are still being able to be treated like shit. I'm glad nobody cares that you can fucking, you know, slap your shrimp and it'll be all right.
Mm-hmm. Shrimp, the cockroaches of the sea.
I love shrimp, but you know, I had crawfish the other day. I'm like, fuck, crawfish isn't even worth it, man.
No, it's really not, for at least not to me. I don't taste that big of a difference.
No, I like half the damn thing.
I only like shrimp if it's deep fried and breaded.
Really?
Yep.
You're missing out.
That's what I've been telling him his whole life.
I don't know, man.
So, if you ever want to take a trip on the wild side, you can go get some, you know, camarones a la diabla, Mexican dish. And it's like really, you know.
Devil shrimp?
Yeah, pretty much. It's hot. It's delicious.
You've just alienated him from so many points right now based off of that one dish. You don't even know. First of all, him being a little too ethnic for his taste, right? Spicy. He can't understand what the hell you said.
No, I did. I think these shrimp probably, like in my mind, probably have like a goatee and maybe a pointy tail, right?
They removed the pitchfork, so you're okay.
I made a deal with the shrimp. It's cool.
Dude, but like a good ceviche or a fucking shrimp cocktail? Come on.
Yeah, man. Ceviche.
Remember that shrimp cocktail we ate in Texas? That ruined that shrimp cocktail for me, dude, buddy.
That was not shrimp cocktail, man. That was white people shrimp cocktail, man. It was ketchup and fucking shrimp.
It was still, yeah, not good.
And to piggyback off of that, I have a friend that moved to Texas. And one of the first things I asked him is like, well, fuck, how's the Mexican food over there? He's like, dude, this ain't Mexican food. It is some Tex-Mex bullshit. There is no good Mexican food out here. Yeah, and besides that, he loves fucking Texas. But that's the one part he does miss about California.
They all think their shit's better. Potter, now, I hate to bring this up on the podcast, but that's your future.
It's looking right? It's looking like it.
Potter's gonna jump over to Tex-Mex territory.
It fucking wasn't that bad over there, dude. I went out of my way to go find some good Mexican food. Fucking looked like I went to the fucking ghetto to go get some handmade tacos. They're fucking good. Got some barbacoa tacos.
Was that goat?
No, I think it was beef.
Hmm.
Now, do they have street tacos out there? Or is it just that one place next to that crack house?
I'll Google map it to you later if you want. You can take a look for yourself. But no, I didn't see any taco stands on street corners.
Strike one.
Joe Rogan actually sells street tacos out there. He's the guy.
Joe Rogan has like a fucking God knows how many acre compound out there. Multi-million dollar compound. Where he gets to smoke weed and get high in his compound without anybody batting an eye. Although it's still illegal under Texas law.
Yeah.
So I wonder, did all the all the Republicans from California that said they were going to move to Texas, did they eventually move there?
There's been pretty bad. My cousin just moved. Not my cousin. My sister-in-law just moved there. She had a fucking bid on like 15 different houses before she had to pay over of what they were asking, even be considered to buy the house that she got.
I mean, Isaac's going to move there, so there's another Republican gone.
How are you going to deal with Ted Cruz, Potter?
I think I would take Ted Cruz over Newsom.
Look, I don't like Newsom. Come on, Ted Cruz is a fucking, he's a moron. He's like one of the highest rated morons. Like, and that beard of his looks, oh, I was going to say kind of patchy and ugly, but let me see Potter. No, I'm just kidding. Now, yours looks like a masterpiece compared to his, man. He's just an idiot. He has no like independent thought or anything. Whitey's got it right back there. Look,
not really, but he's got something else.
There he is. Go ahead, please.
No, go ahead. I was going to say this. I've never heard him say anything intelligent at all. But go ahead.
The fact that he was bouncing to Cancun during like Texas's worst fucking, winter storm in record. Like the fact that your elected leader is like, yeah, fuck this. I'm too rich to deal with this bullshit, and bounces out. That speaks volumes of your character.
Oh, and then he said like, well, you know, it was my kid's fault. You know, I told him I didn't want to do it. As soon as I got on the plane, I knew they were going to.
He's like, I knew it was, yes. I knew it was going to happen.
Mm-hmm. And then he throws his kids under the bus on top of that. That is some stellar leadership.
What a father.
What a leader. Fuck.
What a man. Yeah. It's like that 90s. What a man. Take it from there, Whitey.
What a mighty good man.
That was close to it, yeah.
I mean, I don't know.
Are you salt or pepper?
I think I'm pepper.
I would say you're salt. Look how white salt you are. Motherfucker. There's no speck of darkness in you, Whitey.
No, that's just mean.
Even your fucking shadow. Your shadow's not black. It's like translucent or something.
Oh, man.
Fuck. That kind of reminds me of like that Nickelodeon show back in the day where that little that girl was like this big ball of goo that just, Alex Mack. Remember that? Alex Mack?
Yeah, I remember that. It was that chick from Third Rock from the Sun. Larissa Olnick.
Maybe, yeah.
I couldn't afford water, much less cable.
Oh, no, we stole it. The whole neighborhood had it because of my dad. I remember he climbed up on the telephone pole and connected the cable, and then the whole neighborhood had cable after that.
Oh, my God. For some reason, I always remember that Sosa had or knew somebody who had tree spikes.
Oh, yeah, the gaffs. I remember those. I remember what they were called even.
Were you guys using tree spikes when we were in high school?
That was your brother-in-law.
Yeah.
Did you guys actually use those tree spikes? Like, did you try them on and try out that shit?
No. I didn't want to die.
Oh.
I mean, those things are being held together by like fucking paper clips or some shit. I was like, I'm good, man. I don't know why I always thought
you guys were fucking playing with tree spikes or whatever. I'm like, these guys are badasses fucking climbing up shit with tree spikes, dude.
Wait, we didn't hang out with you then, Whitey. How did you know that? Did you follow us? Did you secretly try to be our friend?
I was your friend, you sons of bitches. You just
listen, I threw rocks at you to keep you away. Okay. I don't know where you're getting this perception that we were friends.
Oh my God.
Well, why do we weren't that friendly that year? It was our
I feel like we're still not friends.
I moved your couch, you son of a bitch.
Oh yeah. Well, you did it in an unfriendly manner.
I'm gonna take it back, watch.
You come in tonight, like you break in through my window and you just fucking take my couch.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Anybody sitting in it too, they're collateral at that point.
You can just break the couch there in his house and let him deal with it.
Just ruin the couch.
He can't use it and he can't take it out by himself. It's a win-win.
I'm still really confused as to how you knew that that we're using those spikes or whatever.
No, I remember you guys talking about the tree spikes.
I don't remember talking about the tree spikes.
We never talked about
it. I don't think I would have brought it up in conversation like, hey, look at these tree spikes, guys.
No, you guys were talking about tree spikes. How would I have known if you guys weren't talking about
tree spikes? That's exactly what we're trying to figure out that way.
Were you hanging out in the next door? Because we knew what was next door.
I was Dale Gribbling you guys. I had one of those little like megaphone things where you can amplify sound.
Because there was a very
pocket sand.
Friendly person next door.
Wait. Oh.
Did you get molested by the guy next door? Where is this conversation going?
No, that's where you were. Next door.
Watching us. Okay. No, I thought that for some reason you were talking about the guy next door and that was overly friendly. Never mind.
I love how Whitey would tell those stories, like things like that, right? He'll say, like, oh, that guy. And people would take him seriously. Like, what are you talking about? Like, every time we were at the bar, Whitey would come back from the bathroom and be like, oh man, that Frank, yeah, he still does a great job every time. Who the fuck's Frank? Who was Frank?
I don't know. I still don't know who Frank was.
Whitey would be like, well, you know, he's a guy who, you know, he massages your ass cheeks as you after you take a piss. You're like, what? You're like, you don't know Frank? He massages your ass cheeks. And everybody would think he's serious and shit.
The things they paid me for.
I thought it was funny, buddy. I thought it was funny. Now you're embarrassed. I'm embarrassed.
Good job, Fabian.
Do you guys remember the fucking... I was just reminiscing about this the other day. Do you guys remember the stupid-ass... classroom project videos we used to do and shit. I'm not talking about way back in Crans, because the only person I would have known about that would have been Whitey. But even in high school, we made those stupid ass videos, and they all of a sudden just turned into fucking backyard wrestling.
I fucking vividly remember those videos.
I remember editing those.
We had the Passion of Macbeth.
The Passion of Macbeth. Yes. That was our masterpiece.
I do not remember this story. Go on, sir.
I would pay hundreds of dollars to get that video footage back.
Dude, so would I. That was like before you could have a camera on any phone, you know, just easily disposable. We had to like scrounge up for a camera. We had to record. We had to have somebody with like professional equipment edit it. And it was like super creative and super, super good.
Well, it started off where I was Lady Macbeth at the dinner scene. We're playing the Hunter Hearst Helmsley WWF song, right? And for whatever reason, everybody was getting slapped on the ass. Like, and then I remember specifically the teacher's like, well, it would have been a good video, but I don't know why you guys included all the ass grabbing. Come on, guys. Playing grab ass or whatever.
Miss Frank did it.
Dude, what happened? Like, we did stellar editing, and we had a soundtrack, and, like, our story was, you know, it had a beginning, middle, and end. Like, it was really good, but she gave me a B.
Oh, yeah, that's bullshit. That shit was clearly a fucking A+.
Yeah, like, some dude that, like, spent, like, 3 minutes recording, like, this little soliloquy, he got an A, and I was like, how the fuck did he get an A, and I got a B? I had, like, a crew of 20, and, like, extras and everything, and I had a soundtrack and professional editing. She's like, yeah, and you also had Jesus getting suplexed or backbreaking people.
What class was this for? What the fuck?
It's English. Junior English or senior English?
I think it was senior, maybe.
Wrong. But I remember, yeah, we did some big things, man. Well, that's why I remember, because the Jackass movie came out. And I was explaining, you know, how back then, everybody wanted to be Jackass, mm-hmm. right? So we started filming ourselves doing stupid shit. And I'm like, somehow it always turned into backyard wrestling, right? Mm-hmm. And I remember, yeah, we did the dinner scene because that was easy. Didn't really take much. And then I became Jesus, somehow traveling throughout the desert of Almani, aka Parkway Drive. And you were dressed in army fatigues and shit, whipping me for some reason down the street, offending everybody, like all the Catholics and everybody, right? We were getting honked at, yelled at. I think some cholos were getting ready to shoot us.
I remember.
But yeah, wow. Then all of a sudden it turns into like this epic backyard wrestling scene where people are literally jumping off the roof. And I'm like, look, anytime people filmed the video, I was asked to come in as a backyard wrestler. And I explained ahead of time, look, I'm like, you know, if you want me to powerbomb you, I'm going to powerbomb you, right? If you ask me to try to put you through a table, you know, they don't break, but I'm going to try to put my best to put you through a table.
Put you through a table. Like,
right? And so anytime anybody asks me, oh, you know, yeah, you know, be in our backyard wrestling scene, I would do it, right? And so we have people jumping off the top. And I remember really fucking powerbombing the shit out of somebody on the grass. And then afterwards, you really powerbombed me. Like, what the hell?
What the fuck do you think was going to happen?
You did that shit to me, too. What happens if you really hurt somebody? So,
wait. Oh.
What would you have done?
Not my house.
He hurt his neck and he didn't want to wake up anymore.
Right, yeah. He fell on his head and now he doesn't talk right.
Wait. All right, so back to this thing. So did Jesus beat up people and he also got beat up?
Or no, so, got beat up? So what happened was we were in an epic battle fight, right? And the protagonist was like kicking the antagonist, or the antagonist, the bad guy, was kicking the shit out of the good guy, right? And like we cut to scene and like we even had different angles, man. Like we had some kid up in the roof recording and like it cuts to scene, right? Like, and it's the, you know, the kid's recording from the roof. And then you hear somebody off camera yell, "Save me, Jesus!" And then the guy tags in Jesus, who's Fabian. And then
the Undertaker music.
With the Undertaker music. And then the bad guy starts fighting Jesus.
Okay.
It all made sense. It all made perfect sense. Totally. And it was fucking beautiful, too, at the same time.
Yeah, that Jesus was in the background in the crucifix. And somebody was like, "Save me, Jesus!" And then Jesus reached out and got tagged in.
I played multiple characters. I was Jesus and Lady Macbeth. It was probably my best roles ever.
You were Lady McJesus, if you think about it.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Anyways.
I had some range, yeah.
Yeah. Well, I mean, we got a beat for that, because she stifled my creative process.
Well, she knew you were going to become a plumber one day anyway.
He goes, "That's another one that's going to the fucking army."
Let's not waste our time. We have limited resources here in Almani, California. I'm not going to waste them on that piece of shit.
Let's focus more on the Asian kids again. Yeah, but there was that one, the Passion of Macbeth, and my brother asked, "Well, why'd you call it the Passion of Macbeth?" I'm like, "Well, there was a Passion of the Christ at the time. What does Christ have to do with Macbeth? Like, if only you know."
Yeah.
Watch this and you'll find out.
I swear, man, whoever has that tape, I will offer hundreds of dollars for that.
Dude, I would offer so much money for that. That is our childhood.
And then we also had like the Jack in the Box ones, right? Where
dude.
Oh yeah, the head.
I didn't do much of those. I remember we even helped my younger brother do like a commercial for his eighth grade class, right? For a product that was basically steroids. It was like a power of steroids.
Remember that.
And so we had you as like this blonde haired weakling. We had a blonde wig, right? And you were getting punked by like Jack in the Box or something. And as soon as you took your steroids, you turned into me. Right, we even have the same shirt, same color shirt and everything. And then I wore the wig, right? And I beat up Jack in the Box.
Do you think maybe Andre likes Jack in the Box a lot, and he saw that as a kid, and he was like, I like Jack in the Box so much, and now I like steroids. Maybe now that's why he does steroids.
that really could have been it. That might have been the pivotal moment there.
Yeah.
Do you remember? Do you remember the fake shake?
Yeah.
We would go into Burger King or something, and the Jack, and somebody would order a milkshake, and then Jack would come in and slap it out of his hand. That's a fake shake.
I kind of remember that commercial.
Wow. Yeah, but I remember one time too. I was at Sosa's house dressed as a Jack in the Box, and we were supposed to be filming a scene where, you know, for what it was, just random. I don't even know what it was for. It was for a project or something. It was for a project. I think a Spanish project somehow or something. Mm-hmm. And my role was to sit in the bathroom looking like I'm taking a shit, with the Jack in the Box hat on, head on, right? So I move my boxers up to, like if they're like fucking like little underwear and shit, and then I have like my sweatshirt hanging over, you know, the front of my legs and everything, so it looks like I'm taking a shit, right? And I have the Jack in the Box head on. But unfortunately, nobody put like a sign up that said like, you know, filming or anything like that. And I had a Sosa's family, his sister, I think, walk in on me as Jack in the Box taking a shit. And
oh, man.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm like, it's a scene. It's a scene.
You're like, don't be sorry.
Well, I don't know what kind of weird shit you're into. I'm out of here.
I think I just slowly turned the head and just threw my shoulder up like,
get back here and look me in the eyes.
But this is the weird shit that we did. And had we had YouTube back then, I think it would have been YouTube sensations.
We might have been a little bit ahead of the curve, you know? Because we weren't doing like straight up jackass shit. We were doing like characters and funny shit.
Yeah, and I think, well, because if you look at YouTube now, and I've had this conversation with a few people on the podcast, some of that shit's like dumb, man. People will watch like, oh, watch this person open a box, and they'll have like 10,000 views or, you know, 50,000 views or whatever, right? Mm-hmm. Watch this person, you know, make facial expressions to this video, right? And again, it'll have so many views and whatnot, and I have no idea how they do that. I've actually been enthralled by a couple of different things on YouTube.
First, reaction videos to people reacting to videos.
Ugh. None of those for me, Potter. You can stick with those.
Fuck no.
I'll stick with watching Little Russian Hezbollah. You guys ever heard of Hezbollah?
Heard of Hezbollah, but never heard of Little Russian Hezbollah.
Yeah.
That's good. You don't know Hezbollah, the little guy?
No.
Oh, come on.
I think Hezbollah is a terrorist organization in Palestine, sir.
That's exactly what I thought as well.
You never see, you've seen those two little guys that look like
the little Russian kids. Kid is supposed to be it's associated with a Khabib or something, sort of.
Yeah, little Khabib.
I don't know little Khabib's name, but
I'm so confused.
He's hilarious. So anyway, him, and I've been watching those stupid Detroit survival training guys take videos.
Oh God, that guy!
Feeling very confident about yourself, Fabian.
He's gonna get a lot of stupid people killed.
Oh fuck!
And the videos are funny because they'll have the guys that will be like, okay, I remember the training, and then they do the, you know, the defense technique, and then they'll end up in heaven. Right? Damn it. And they're like, no, damn it. Like I did the move the guy showed me, and they're still dead.
Oh man, I saw somebody review that, and they're like, I pray to fucking God he's just trolling everybody. That's what somebody said one time. It's like this guy's either the worst human being on the planet or the greatest troll ever.
That is some level of commitment if that's a troll. Holy shit.
Well, his argument is that, you know, this stuff's not meant to be like, you know, any kind of, you know, tournament fight or anything like that. It's life and death situations, right? But like, you call it life and death, it's a certain death at that point, you know? Like, I think there's
I think your chance of death increases if you even try that shit that he's trying to pedal off.
There's like one thing that he does that's legitimate is that Z-lock, which is like a wrist lock, right? That thing is legitimate. Like, you can take somebody down with it. But you have to be, you know, skilled enough to know how to get it, and you have to be quick enough, and you do have to be strong enough. Like, he tries to say, like, you don't have to be, you know, strong. You can be like a woman and take down a guy, like a grown man. But unfortunately, it's not going to work, you know? But I don't know. I just get stuck watching those videos, though, because each one is, like, more, like, ridiculous than the last, you know?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, okay, that's like when everybody thought, like, Krav Maga was the next, like, you know, thing to you know, top every other martial arts out there, right?
Dude, Krav Maga's horseshit.
What are you talking about, man?
Oh, God.
Can you do Krav Maga without kicking the nuts? Then it's not Krav Maga.
I trust Whitey's fifth grade karate more than I trust Krav Maga and Detroit survival training.
You didn't knock that fifth grade karate, all right?
I said I trusted more. You had a medal and everything.
Speaking of which, so I'm trying to get my son into martial arts, right? And I'm looking at the local karate studios. And they're like, yeah, you know, bring him in for a free lesson, whatever. And I go in there, and the black belts, they have like five black belts in there. And they're either a 14-year-old little girl, or dudes that are clearly over 300 pounds. And I'm like, bro, you're the black belt? He's like, yeah, you know, I'm sensei so-and-so. I'm like, dude, I'm pretty sure you can't even kick above my shin right now. Like, what the fuck, man? What are you going to be teaching my kid?
Challenge him to a kumite. Like that, and then you get the karate class.
Kumite. Kumite.
Like that guy, Stingray, what do you call it? Cobra Kai?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
I'm just like, I don't feel confident that you're going to teach my kid how not to get his ass kicked.
Dude, that show is getting better and better.
I love that show.
I need to watch the new season.
Yeah.
Been liking it.
But yeah, you guys see that Cuphead cartoon that came out?
No.
It's on Netflix.
The what cartoon?
It's called Cuphead. It's got like, it's like all that old animation, like Woody Woodpecker style cartoons and stuff. It's kind of crazy. Anyway, it's worth to watch if you like cartoons. It was a video game. It's a fucking, it's a hand-drawn video game, and it makes you want to fucking tear your fucking hair out if you've ever played it. It's like a platformer. Check it out.
So how'd your kid do in the karate class, Osa?
What happened to wrestling?
I don't know, man. It didn't really take to it. Like, I tried, you know. I tried for like 3 months, and he didn't take to it. So it's like, I have to pull him out.
Dude. Yeah. My kid has been begging for me to take her back to wrestling.
Oh, yeah?
I finally... She was sick, and we didn't want to take her back just yet because we just had the kid born. So we're like, let's not bring a whole bunch of germs in so soon, so fast.
Mm-hmm.
So we finally said, all right, I'm getting out of work early enough. I remember to grab all her stuff. Let's go to wrestling. And before the day even started, I didn't even tell her that we were going to go. She was like, wrestling, wrestling, wrestling. We fucking get there. You know what she says? Where's Marcus, Dad?
Oh,
like, I don't know. He's still got time. We're here like 10 minutes early.
Oh, that sucks.
See what you did there, Potter? You just wanted to prove that you're the better dad, didn't you?
Yeah, horrible. Piece of shit.
Not even what he said. He's like, he pulled her aside. He's like, Marcus is a quitter.
Damn. You're Asian. You will not quit.
Hey, you know, the good thing, though, is there's a lot of, like, like girls sports now, like that have opened up, like a lot of women's tournaments and things going on.
If you follow his the dude's page, like the kids CIF and like state championships were like all like the past couple weeks that he's been going to tournaments, like Fridays, Saturdays, and Sundays. It's a lot of girls, man, been fucking placing.
Yeah. California's getting really big with girls wrestling. Yeah, that'll probably get you a full ride scholarship for sure if you keep her in there.
To what fucking school? They're all cutting their wrestling programs.
No, the women's wrestling is growing.
In college?
In college, yeah.
Because I was like, last I heard, like fucking Harvard or Stanford or one of them fucking
they're
schools.
Men's programs.
Okay.
It has to be equal.
Damn.
But the women's programs are growing. They even had like a full-time, they made a big deal about, like, I think it's Iowa now that has like a full-time, I forget if it's Iowa or what, but had a full-time women's coach for a women's team.
Holy shit.
Damn.
So it's getting better for them. But that's what I'm saying, like, now's the time to jump on. So Potter, make sure that she has a good discipline and a very focus. Discipline. Repeat up. Discipline.
Okay.
And focus.
I'll tell her just like that if that's how you want me to do it.
I mean, listen, Potter, you don't naturally have that Asian accent, so you have to practice it, right?
Or, you know, tell your in-laws to tell her.
But it has to come from the father, right? Mm. Like, oh, listen here, Con Junior. You need to be very disciplined and focus.
Sounds like some Eric Cartman shit right there.
That's exactly where I got it from, yeah.
Nailed it.
All I heard was ficus.
But she's gonna be doing that the wrestling for a while.
I'd want her to. I take her whenever I can. I'm just busy at the shop, man. But yeah, I drop her off, man. She fucking has a blast. Technically the class is supposed to start for 4-year-olds, and I threw her in at 3.5. She got some stuff.
Maybe we can get Whitey back in there in the kids' class.
I still got my singlet.
I think I want to see you squeeze back into your singlet there, buddy.
Oh, God.
I was looking at the team picture from when we were seniors,
mm-hmm.
right, the other day, and I'm like, fuck, we used to all be in much better shape. Whitey, you had some triceps there. You almost had some.
I had muscles.
I mean, there was something there.
There was less of other stuff.
And more of other stuff.
No, mostly just less of other stuff.
Son of a bitch.
Why weren't you like close? I know you wrestled 152, but weren't you close to like 140 something?
I wrestled at 60s and I was close to 50s.
There you go.
I broke 52 at the end there, which is probably a bad thing.
Isaac, what did you wrestle, 155 or 150?
45, right?
I was 52, and then I got down to 45, and then the lowest I ever got was 42 that I actually, like, checked it.
I started my wrestling career freshman year, and I made 112s at one tournament.
Yeah.
They're like, wow. You're skinny. Lose a pound.
Lose a pound.
I was like, Coach, I don't even have food to eat at home. What do you want me to do?
You probably could have made 103 if they really forced you to, you know, lose all the water weight.
Yeah, I could have.
Go piss if and take still, a shit.
If you're still talking, time. Yeah, I was gonna say if you're still talking, you can spit.
Here's two plastic bags. Three hoodies.
Man. The worst.
None of us would have wrestled if they tested our piss for hydration.
The worst I remember was Alan sitting in a van in front of the heater, like,
yep.
trying to cut weight.
I remember Coach Tring on the heater. He's like, Alan's got to cut weight, so everybody just suck up the heat. Like, just don't bitch about it. Go, Alan. He's just like rocking back and forth, trying to keep little body movement, little what's the fucking thing? Side.
The coach told him not to eat his bread crust.
Got another guest coming in, guys. I don't know who it is. iPhone. Let me see what we got here. Let's see.
I feel like it's the Royal Rumble.
I don't know who it is. Let's see. So it's iPhone.
Oh.
And still iPhone.
There he is.
Ah, George.
Hey, what's up, man?
We're cracking.
How you been?
That's like the Whitey was saying. It was a surprise entrant.
Yeah, I just got back and did a couple. Had a couple of privates right now at 7 and 8. So I just got home.
Nice. Yeah, Whitey said you were like a surprise entrant in the Royal Rumble right now.
Yeah. That's my favorite. That's my favorite pay-per-view too.
Yeah. Well, yeah, man. Thanks for joining us. We had another guest drop by earlier. She's talking about the solar system and shit. So I don't know how much you could top, if you could top that.
the bar is so high, man.
A big part of the podcast, especially early on. You're talking about food and shit and
the community. State championships, wrestling, community.
Yeah.
A little bit of very fighting. I think we did a little bit of everything.
Yep.
I think the food is the best part. We got to do a couple more.
I thought we were going to do a couple more food episodes, man. What happened?
So I'll take the blame for this one. Right? I am in no condition to be out there fucking eating food and filming myself. But after I watched back those taco videos, I'm like, what the fuck? Who's that guy? I'm like, I know I've always, I've never been... what do you call it? Like Sosa size or something like that. But I was like, what the fuck? What's going on in these videos, man?
No, but nobody's not going to trust a skinny guy that fucking that the food's good.
Right. I swear to God, though, now every time I talk and tell people about Petrillo's pizza, I call it date night pizza because of you.
Petrillo's.
That was perfect. Date night pizza. That's what it is.
I gotta put one of the Beckhams on me.
Which one you said the background? The Married with Children? Or which one?
Yeah, no, okay. I see you guys all have backgrounds.
Ah.
Okay, I see it.
Ah.
My cream.
Damn.
Nice.
Can you see it?
Not all of it, because you're your phone is upward instead of sideways, but...
Oh, I see. Can you get it? No. Can't get it. And it shows the tanks. It says, that's a Russian tank, and then our tank's a non-binary pink tank with... Oh, damn. Right there, you go.
You know, because... So you see people like in... I don't know. Do you still go to like VFWs or anything like that, or no?
No, I haven't in years.
Oh. I was wondering, or like, I know your nephew's still in the military. Do you think like that, where a lot of the kids are like nowadays are kind of like really soft or anything like that, or?
I mean, the military is a microcosm of the art, the culture. And I mean, the culture is what it is right now. So of course you're going to see that leak into the military. I mean, what are you going to do? You're going to exclude all these kids from joining, and then you won't have a military?
You think, though, there's still kind of like the, like, they're still in good hands kind of thing, where, you know what I'm saying? Like, you still have to be, like, toughened up and, still do things a certain way. But, like, especially with all, like, the Me Too shit all of a sudden, right?
You know, man, I was fortunate enough to leave before all those big changes happened. I mean, for example, back when I was in, men only in the infantry, that's it. It was dudes only, artillery, infantry, Cav Scout, no women allowed. Now you have women in there. I don't know how the culture has changed. I mean, I hope to say that there's still some hard chargers out there. I'm sure there are. I'm sure there are some very tough women that are able to do the job. Like I said, at the end of the day, the military is a reflection, a microcosm of the society we live in. And I'm sure there's people out there saying they, them, it's her, but their pronouns,
Well, at least you didn't have Whitey in there, though, right?
Oh, that's for sure. God dang. I'll take the damn over Whitey any day.
We got the grill back there, George?
Yeah, little hot dog holders.
Oh, shit. I don't use those. Maybe that woo guy.
Hey, you better not pick them up, and then fucking eat them like that off the stick. Oh yeah, that's that guy. Dedicated guy. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I think we were supposed to do more, you know, food videos. Again, I'm not opposed to it. I'll be out there doing another one at some point. Those are actually the most fun. I think they got the most like interaction on Instagram. But surprisingly, actually, I think one of yours on YouTube got a really, really high amount. I think I got like 50,000 on one of yours, George. I think it was which one? Let me check real quick. The last one, that takes a village.
Oh yeah, yeah. I always, because people always seem to be asking where's the best pizza in Amani. So like on Amani Happenings on Facebook. So I always post that video. I always post it in the comments.
Nice.
And everybody's always like, nah, bro. Everybody's still at the post. I was like, dog, it's right here. It's there. I mean,
we did the cheese test, man.
Yeah. You got to be.
Did you say somebody changed their cheese because of you guys?
Oh, yeah. Who was it? Oh, Reels. I went and the guys, oh, they're like, hey, I said, oh, the one from the video, like, oh yeah, I remember, like, actually we changed our cheese. I'm like, oh damn, their cheese, that's, I think their dough or something else too, but yeah, their cheese, I know for sure.
I had actually Reels last night. Their fucking meat pizza is amazing. Like,
oh yeah,
kinds of fucking meatballs on it and shit.
You went to that one or the one in Montebello?
Oh, you know what, I got it delivered, so I'm not sure. That might have been the Montebello one.
Yeah, because Montebello is pretty probably a little bit different, but they're like equal though. But they taste a little different.
Now with DoorDash and shit, man, I don't even know where shit's coming from anymore.
Oh yeah.
So you're right. It was probably Montebello because it took a little longer.
Yeah.
I still gotta try that Baby Bros. It's right over here by my house.
Oh, the Baby Bros. There's a new one. I know they make one in San Dimas now. Then there's the one we went to on Lower Azusa. There's the one in South Amani on Rush.
Yeah, I live next to the one on South Amani.
Okay,
and Rush.
Actually, my buddy, he just opened his tattoo shop next to the one that we went to. So I'm there at least once a week, get a little slice, because they sell slices now. So you get a slice and a soda for like $3 or $4 or something.
Oh, that's cool. Yeah,
that's a good deal.
Yeah, and it's for the kids right there at the Royal. So the kids from Royal get out. I think they stop selling like at like 4 o'clock, 3:30. So the kids get out, go, and there's always a line out there. Kids getting a big slice of pizza and a soda, and then they just take off.
Yeah, that's
pretty good. Yeah.
Yeah, that's good business right there.
Yeah, because there's not a lot of places around here that sell just a slice.
Yeah, for real.
I think anybody.
So I had this one. See, like this. Now I didn't realize there's like different pizza styles out there, right? Like you mentioned that date pizza.
Yeah. And there's like the square, the Detroit style, and then there's New York style. There's New York's a little bit more burnt. Like you can see a little more crust on it, like a little more burnt char. A lot of different ones. I watch that Dave Portnoy every day. I watch his pizza videos every day. That kept me through the freaking pandemic. Yeah, that's what I wait for, 3 o'clock.
See, he prefers New York style pizza, obviously. And I didn't think New York style pizza was that good until I had one from Pasadena, South Pasadena, called Tomato Pie Pizzeria. That shit was good. Even just the damn cheese pizza, I was like, because I mean, for me, I got to have toppings, man. I got to load on. At least pepperoni, you know, but that shit was good. You ever want good? I mean, I don't have a scale for New York pizza. I'm not the fucking master at that, but if you ever want good New York style pizza, in my opinion, you got to get a fucking tomato pie in South Pasadena.
Well, he did two spots in LA. He did one the last time he came down and one this week. And he gave he did a couple spots, but two of the spots he gave a 8.2 and 8.4. So in his thing, that's like you'll drive an hour 45 minutes to get it. That's like, it's a real good, like 8+, like that's a fucking awesome pizza.
Was in LA?
Yeah, Prime Pizza in LA. And I forgot the other one. My brother actually went. He said it was good. He said it was like a hour and a half wait. Because once he gives like a high score,
that lines up the door.
It was like that taco guy. Remember the fucking guy?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
That ended guy. Up going to see Ray?
Yeah, well, my buddy actually, the taco guy. Oh, the one with the beard, right? The Kings fan? You always wearing Kings hat or something?
Yeah, guy snaps all the time.
Yeah, he, my buddy actually hit him up. He said they charge, he charged like $300 to see your spot.
God damn.
Unless it's really recommended. Like, oh. Someone kept on hitting him up, like, he'll go. But, like, if you want him to go see your spot, he charges, like $300 to $600 or something.
Oh, okay. Like, if you're requesting, hey, come see me.
Yeah. And I guess that's why I see a lot of his scores. He's like 9.1, 9.3. Like, well, how do you give everybody, like, a 9 point something? Like, I know every taco ain't the best. So, yeah, they're probably paying him, get a little high score.
Yeah, when I thought he was kind of like, I don't know about this guy. When he rated, like, fucking Del Taco's tamale, like, the fucking 7 point something or whatever.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he gets like, out of there sometimes. Yeah. A lot of you think he does that shit anymore because I used to see his things every morning. I don't even see doing it anymore.
No.
He ran out of spots.
So. He's already burnt out. Yeah. So what's been going on with you guys? Is this ready for this pandemic to end and World War III or?
World War III, yeah. Apparently, it's no big deal.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Pretty nasty, Monica.
It'll be over in 2 years.
The solar system.
Yeah. Yeah, it's crazy. It's fucking crazy time right now. And I'm working in the schools. I work with sex special ed, but adults, like 18, 19, 20 years old, and they're just amazed. Like, they're just scared. They're just, like, they don't know what to think about it.
Yeah.
Like, we watch at CNN 10 every day, and we have to ask them, you know, if you guys don't feel comfortable, you guys go outside, whatever. But that's pretty good. It's scary for a lot of people.
I actually want to bring something up, George, because brought this up in a few podcast episodes before. Why do you listen to all the episodes? I think Potter listens to most of them, Sosa listens to none. I was like, when Whitey first heard yours, he goes, is that the same George that went to Mountain View? I'm like, yeah. He goes, but I thought he was the bully. I thought he was the jerk, right? And then he goes, but I goes, after listening to him, I'm like, he's like, oh, a different point of view.
Yeah.
And I think that's something we touched on the podcast a couple of times where you kind of were able to switch it up. So that's been pretty cool, even with Whitey over here.
I felt like I said, like even like my gym I want to open is, we call it Bully Muay Thai, but it's like, I mean, you hear the podcast. It's like me, I wanted to bully the bully, like make you fun of people like these. And it's always like the ones that like I said, that one story about my friend's brother that was, you know, special ed, got picked up on a little yellow bus. And he's like, kept on saying the R word in the class. Hey, you know, it's not a nice word to say. He's like, why? Wow, yeah. And she started talking about his brother. Right when the teacher turned off the lights, you know, she wrote in the thing with the TV because we're going to watch a movie. She turned off the lights. I slapped the dog shit out there. Like, he thought it was like, some people just think they're tough. Like, oh. And that's just what I mean. Like, yeah, I was a bully. I was probably just looked like a dickhead, a big guy, whatever. But I mean, I just like bully the bullies.
You just didn't look friendly. You didn't have a friendly look to you.
Definitely. Yeah, yeah. That's
I think that's what it was.
I would say, especially like all the times I go to the job, like, I work a couple of different facilities and I'm like, man, you look like a fucking asshole. But then all you do is joke around, talk crap, like make fun of people. You help the kids. Like, it's weird. Well, I recently, I was working at Alhambra High School and they didn't give me a chance because within 4 weeks of working there, the principal asked me to be removed from campus because of my tattoos. So that was kind of, that was like the first time. I was like, Alhambra, really? Like, you guys even asked me to get switch schools because of my tattoos? Like,
didn't Larry used to work there? Or he does work there still?
Larry, I don't know. I know Beto, he went to school. He was after you guys left because he was like 2 years younger than me. Maybe three. I don't know. He's like a Spanish teacher there, but I don't know anybody else that works there.
I thought Larry, Matt's uncle.
Oh, no, he's at Marquepo.
Oh, yeah, that's right. He switched over there.
But
he was at San Gabriel and Alhambra. And, okay, nice.
Yeah, he was at all those. Yeah, San Gabriel. He was all in the area. I think he went to Bishop Milan for a little bit in Puente. But yeah.
They just straight up said, nope, we don't want you with the.
Well, the supervisor called me and he just said, hey, bro, can you call me after? And they had me finish the day too. That's what sucked. So they're like, hey, can you call me after you get out? I was like, okay. So I called him. I was like, hey, man, I got some bad news. I was like, what's up, man? He's like,
you know, district called, asked me to switch your school because, you know, you don't fit into their program. So he kind of made a little bit, kind of big thing about it. He found out, like, oh yeah, you know, his tattoos and stuff, he just still fit in. I was there every day. I was helping the kids. Like, I had no problems with the kids. Kids like me, but I ended up at a better spot in my Wheeler Union now. So working with more like adults and a lot of people that have tattoos.
They didn't give you an option to, or tell you at the beginning to cover your tattoos?
I mean, well, I have them on my hands, my neck, my ears. So it's kind of hard. But no, they didn't say nothing. They never said nothing. They seen me like walking first day. They didn't say nothing. I was there for a month. But it was weird because that week, so we had an interim principal for the first 3 weeks. And that week, the principal that was going to be the principal for now on was there. So I think it was this. I think it was her.
Oh, so it's a new principal. She's trying to walk around swing dick, right?
Yeah. Actually, that day she had punked one of the other aides too. Like, hey, you got to get to class. He's like, I'm helping one of the kids that they forgot their phone and they got to check in with COVID. You know, the COVID checks in. They got to look at their phone and stuff. She will hurry up and get to class after. He's like, damn, I'm not even a student. The fuck you talking to me like that for? Yeah. So
yeah, a lot of people like can
tell them hi. Tell them hi. They're gonna be home right now, okay? Okay, they'll be home right now, okay?
I heard her say something about Obama. That's a smart
one. Yeah. Yeah, they're gonna come go hi, go sleep. Yeah, man, it kind of sucked, but I liked the kids. I mean, I was going to, like, you know, relationship with them. Like, you were cool. And then, but the spot I'm at now is better. Get out earlier. I mean, I could coach more. Have more time to get up more privates.
So
that's cool.
So, the gym, you're really kind of, you're there every day, right? The Muay Thai?
Actually, I haven't opened my own spot yet. I'm helping my buddy out at his in Upland, the shop off of Central. It's a boxing gym, but he lets me do Muay Thai there. He's going to do my privates. So I helped him out because COVID got me. Well, not got me, but one of my job, my full-time job had closed down. So I was out of work for a while. So all the savings I had open again, fucked me. So right now I'm just starting all over again. But hopefully soon, hopefully by the end of the year, this year, I have a gym, I have a spot. I've been helping a lot of people, a lot of big people. So, okay. We're trying to get into, Nate Diaz, if he fights Poirier, we're trying to get in that camp as like a main sparring partner. So that'll be a good one.
No, cool. As far as like community wise, man, I don't know if you're in the loop or not, but you heard anything about like local, like Mountain View, like what's going on with the wrestling program or anything? We've been out of the loop with that.
Yeah, I know their girls were doing good. Like two of their girls made it to, I want to say, state.
Oh yeah, I think.
Honestly, I didn't see no guys. I seen the two girls like we're doing real good, and I think that's like a lot in the area because even Almani they had like one or two girls, Mountain View.
I think like Arroyo just finished fifth for state for girls.
Oh yeah. See, so all these dudes like all the other programs around here, the girls are just taking over. They're becoming, I guess, tougher than the dudes, or they're just out there working.
Yeah, there's a lot of opportunity for them.
Yeah,
so that's what we're telling Potter to make sure that his daughter has plenty of discipline.
yeah. I got my niece right now. She knows how to do the 1-2 knees. I was like, I don't know about wrestling, but she'll be a kickboxing or something.
Yeah, I think I was talking to Gomez the other day, and, you know, he's assistant principal now, and he's saying that the wrestling room's looking nice and everything, and they're going to put, like, a little wall of fame. I'm like, I wonder if they're going to do that. I mean, really have that many accomplishments. But I'm gonna be like, you know, if you want anybody who had most pins in one season, I still remember 35 pins my senior year. There's no way to back that up, right? No data to back that up other than my memories. So that should be good enough.
I try to watch all that. Look, actually, one of the football coaches, last name's Gaslam, something Gaslam. He coaches. He does wrestling and football. So he's out there. And then who else? I don't know anybody else that's coaching. I know him for sure.
Okay. I hope one year I'm able to just fucking get back out there, man. It's with the work, the way it's been for me, I've never been able to be like, okay, I have a schedule where I can coach now, but we'll see. Maybe one day.
Yeah, I'm actually coaching at, we're actually coaching football at Sarah Vista now.
Oh, nice.
Amani let us, we won a state championship with 16-0, and then they let us walk away. So, I mean, it went on. So, we had service this season. They went 0-8 last year. They didn't win a game. They scored 5 touchdowns all season. So, we're going to have our work cut out for us, but I think we'll be able to do something. Make some noise.
All right. Well, shit, man. I actually want to see if anybody else has anything they want to add, because I know we have a bit till we're almost going to reach like 2 hours here on our end. And I don't want to time it out on Zoom or anything, but anybody else want to add anything to the shit show?
It was good to see George here.
Yeah, I was going to come on earlier too, and then I was on the freeway coming back. I saw, hopefully they're still on.
Sure, man.
Good.
We gotta do an in person. All of us there, grab some tacos, something. Street.
That's
street
what's dog. Up right there. Fuck yeah,
cool.
I go out to all the. They have that whole like in front of Didi's. They have tacos, hot dogs, another taco spot, like the Chulo spot. Maybe let's go hit that one night. Do a little video. Try it out.
Oh, yeah. I'll get a scooter. That way I don't have to walk after watching myself back in those videos. you don't understand how disappointed I am, but, you know, it's time. There's time to fix that.
Well, we're actually, I dropped 1X on my shirt. I'm a 4X now, so. How do you working with
That's
all these
progress. Dudes? That is progress. Yeah.
Working with all these dudes really helped me out.
There you go, man. All right, well, yeah, appreciate having you on, man. I definitely, I think we had a couple of guests, so you know, that was more than I expected. I was like, yeah, nobody's gonna drop in, but we were able to get at least, you know, some of y'all that were a good part of the podcast, so that's good. But yeah, man, fuck, let's. I was gonna say maybe I'll just stop at 100, but at this point, I'm like, I've already got people booked for 102, 103, 104, so let's keep going, see where the fuck it goes, and.
Oh, hell, you made it to 100, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, fuck it. The other ones, I mean, I know people start working. They get in there. I know Hector was going real good. I think he only got a couple in. He started working, so fuck it, 100.
Yeah.
Keep on going.
We'll see where I stop. Maybe one day I'll just be like, fuck this. For now, it's going to keep on going. So
sounds good, man.
Shit show number 10, fucking successful. Nobody else has anything to add, then we'll cut it here and, you know, hopefully we'll see everybody on at some point again. I think we got to do our own, maybe do our own individual episodes again. I kind of feel like we need to retouch that, get some more flavor on that. But we'll see.
Yeah, we got to find some new shit. Yeah, let's do it.
I was hoping we'd get Matt back on because I know you hadn't talked to him in a bit. Last time we talked to him, it was like, oh man, fucking Matt still up to the same old, same old.
Disappear for 2-3 years, come back, make a new Instagram. Like, what the fuck?
Come up with another kid.
Yeah.
All right, then. But appreciate everybody on. Everybody listening at home, definitely appreciate it. Thank you. Good night.
Thank you, man. Thank you.
Podcasts on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, and Google Podcasts. Like, follow, and share on Facebook and Instagram at Ignorance is Strength Podcast and on Twitter at The Ignorance Pod.